Hello, YouTube. We're going to start covering MCreator now, and the next five tutorials will have to do with blocks. One of them is going to cover Techne, which will basically show you how to make custom blocks, and we're going to use it for one of our tutorials that's after that. So today we're just going to cover how to make a basic one and learn basically what everything means, and well, that's basically it. All right, so you're going to click New Element, this button right here. Then you want to type in what your block is. So I have a block that I will be using. Mossy, I don't think it will allow you. No, there'll be errors if you do that. Mossy, marble. All right, so you want to make it so the name won't repeat on any of your other mods. Or elements, I think they call them elements now. They're used to be called mods. So a way to avoid it is to basically put the name of the mod or the element before your mod name. So mine's gonna be Mossy Marble, and I put block before it. Now I'm going to click OK. All right, so we're on our first page. Now, I will cover the render types and TX block option later in the further future tutorials. But right now we're just interested in textures and block dimensions and these two little boxes here. So this is your block texture. This would be your center. That would be your left side, right side, back, top, and bottom. I think that could be the right. I'm not sure. It depends what side it is, but I believe that's the left because this is the face. So but if we click the red button or red box, it will just upload the texture to that box. Same with all the white boxes. Now this red box is required to work with the render types, and again, like I said, we'll cover all that later, but we're just gonna click the blue box, and we're going to upload a texture from our paint.net tutorial. And then we're going to select block. And then we're going to go back, and then we're going to select it again. And make sure it's selected, and select OK. Now that's not too bad of a texture. I'm pretty impressed with it. All right, so now we have our texture in place. Let's cover what these are. Now, the minimum X, Y, and Z are well, I might as well just spit it out there and tell you what it does. It's block bounds. So block bounds is a term in the coding, Java coding for Minecraft, which allows dimensions where the block can be walked up against, or no, it can't be walked through. So if you were to look in around the block edges, it would have a kind of a rim around it, and that's just to show you that, okay, well, this is where the block bounds are. You can't go through that. Now, For a regular block that's square like this, you're going to need to set this to 0 and this to 1. It doesn't go over 1 and it doesn't go below 0. So if you were wanting to make a half slab, you would change this to 0.5, 0.5, like that. And that will take the height from the maximum corner. So again, if you were to look at it from the side, you're going to have one on this side, on the right side of it, and then you're going to have one on the left side, which should be over here. And maximum is up top, minimum is down on the bottom. And if you were to look at it from the top, one would be over here and one would be over here. So, I don't know how to explain it better than that. They're on opposite corners of each other. One's above, one's below, and they're on the opposite side as well. They're flipped. So, yeah. So we're just gonna leave it because we're making a normal block. Now, the next two things I want to cover is don't render as a normal block. This needs to be checked if you're making glass or something transparent that you can see through. Has alpha will allow it to have the property of glass, so you'll be able to see through and use transparent images. If you don't check these, you're going to basically see through the ground, so we don't need that because it's a solid block. Next thing, GUI name. GUI name is the name that is seen in the in the tab or your player slots when you scroll over it. So if I were to call it Mossy Marble, it will show up as Mossy Marble. And if you're thinking, okay, well, we named our mod, why are we naming it twice? We named our element because that's what it needs to be named. This is just to show, okay, like our mod element won't show up, and we won't see that, but we will see this. Hardness, this is how long it takes to mine it. It takes a little bit of math to figure out how long it'll take, but you can follow the instructions here. Resistance, how resistant it is to explosions. So 15 would be a good thing for what I'm making. Has gravity. Now, if you want it to act like sand or gravel, if there's not a block underneath it, it will fall. That check this box. Creative tab, inventory tab. This is basically where you'll find your block if you were in your creative. I'll also cover how to make other ones and add them and everything. Next is dropping property. So tool able to destroy it. This is basically, well, you wouldn't mine stone with a shovel, so you would use a pickaxe, so to speak. So I'm gonna leave that. So that's quite different than harvest level. So okay, so doesn't drop itself. Well, this basically, if you wanted to drop an item such as diamonds, how diamond ore drops diamonds, you would use this and then you would select it and then you choose the drop amount. But you don't really need that because we're just making a simple block right now. Drop amount, this is how much it drops of itself, or the item that you choose. isn't collidable. This basically allows the player to walk right through it. Can provide power, so it will hook up to redstone dust if it can provide power, so it will be act like a redstone torch or a redstone block. Light opacity, this is how much light gets let through. Now, 0 is no light will go through, 255 is all light will go through, and 126 is a little bit of light will go through, but not all of it. A material, this is basically what kind of properties do you want your block to have. Now, if you want it to burn, you want it to have wood properties. If you want, say, I think pumpkin properties will actually face on different sides, and what else? Cactus will go three, grow three higher, something like that, right? Next is sound on step. This is basically what it will sound like when you walk on it. So if you were to walk on the block in game, and it will make a stone sound step. Luminescence, this is basically how much light gives off. It goes up to 15. Basically it acts like a torch or a beacon or something like that. Is unbreakable, is it going to act like bedrock? Will it, can the player destroy it? Harvest level, now this is separate from hardness. Harvest level is basically what kind of tier would you use to break it. So 0 would be wood, 1 would be stone, 2 would be iron, 3 would be diamond. And if you were to do custom, you would type in your, you would choose custom, and then you would choose what tier you want it to be. Now you would also have to make tools, custom tools, to actually fit that tier. So keep that in mind. I'm just going to go say 0, don't really need it. I'm going to change that to 0. Alright, so we're done that page. Particles. Particles are things that are like an enchantment table or a villager when it's hit. What else? There's a whole bunch of them. Explosion particles, flame particles, lava drip. Water dripping, angry, happy, yeah, so then you have the spawn shape, so what kind of shape do you want it to form in? And basically particle spawning radius, so how far out does it spawn? And then particle amount, how many particles spawn at a time. Don't worry about that, that's nothing special, but if you're going to use particles, you just check that box up there. Next is events. Now, I'm not going to cover events just yet. There's a lot to cover with events, so basically I'm just going to tell you what events are. And if you want to play around with it yourself, then you're more than welcome until I finish, get around to doing events. But I have kind of a system of what videos are planned, and it is at the end. So, Events are, well, these things right here, these boxes are triggers. So this, say, if the block was right-clicked by a player, it will trigger an event. So events are all these things on the left. So events are like things that happen when the trigger happens. So it's like a chain reaction. It could remove the block or anything like that, but I'm not going to cover that, like I said. next is crafting and world generation. So you could, if you wanted to, set up a crafting recipe for this, or you could do a furnace recipe down here. Or if you want it to spawn in the world or Nether, you can basically choose a depth of it. And I'm gonna just leave it there. So this is your minimum depth. This is your hot top depth. Think hot and think cold. You're obviously gonna be colder towards as you get further down. All right, so if you want it to spawn in the world, you click that one. If you want it to spawn in the Nether, you click that one. And basically, frequency on chunks. Frequency on chunks is how much is on one chunk and on specific chunks. So this would be how much is in a vein. So I'm gonna bring it to about there and about there. No, more about there. Yeah, maybe just leave it. And that should be good. All right, and then you just click finish, and you're done. That's basically how to make a really simple block. We will be getting into TX blocks next, followed by how to make an ore block, and then we're going to cover techni, and then finally custom blocks. So, one last thing. This basically has to compile it all. So when you're create a mod, it will compile all the stuff that you just coded in. It takes a while, not too long, but it'll basically tell you return zero, all good, and stuff like that. So I believe it will be in green. All right, and I'm going to go into the client, and I'm going to show you basically what we've done, and I'll be right back. Right, so I went mining, and I am back. So now that you can see that this is how big that it actually spawns in. So that's basically how much spawns in one vein, and that's how close they can spawn together. So, yeah, I've kind of mined out between the two of them. As you can see, that they're about the size of a coal, and almost as frequent as coal as well, maybe a little more frequent than them. So yeah, that's about it. So if you like my tutorials, like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.